Solve each equation for the indicated variable. 5x plus 7y is equal to 42. We're asked to solve for y. So we identify the variable term. We have a 7y. We remove any other terms from that side of the equation. So I'll subtract 5x from both sides. So that gives us then 7y is equal to, now 42 and 5x are not like terms. So we can write 42 minus 5x. Now, there's nothing wrong with this. However, it is common practice to write the variable term first. So I will rewrite this as 7y equals negative 5x plus 42. Now, we were asked to solve for y. So we need to divide through by 7. And so then this isolates the y, and so we have y is equal to, I mean, there's nothing wrong with writing negative 5x plus 42 over 7. But again, this is not a common way to write it. More commonly, we would write this as y equals, and writing, we have a negative 5 over 7, so a negative 5 sevenths x, and then we would have a 42 over 7, applying basically a distributive property. 42 over 7 is 6, so y equals negative 5 sevenths x plus 6. That's how we would write this equation solved for y. 3r plus 9 is equal to 3 fourths of 4t minus 8. Let's simplify the right-hand side by applying the distributive property. So we have 3r plus 9 is equal to 3 fourths of 4t minus 3 fourths of 8. And we can reduce here between, let's see, the 4s. The 4 and the 4s leave 1s. And the second term, we have the 4 and the 8, leaves a 1 and a 2. And so this simplifies as, let's see, 3r plus 9 is equal to 3t minus 6. Now we can clearly identify the variable term we wish to isolate, and I will add 6 to both sides. Yielding 3r plus 15 is equal to 3t. And to isolate the variable t, I'll divide through by 3. And like I did in the previous exercise, I'm going to break up this big fraction into two fractions, two terms, 3 thirds r plus 15 thirds is equal to t. And simplifying each of those fractions, I have 1r, or more simply r, plus 5 is equal to t. And then just writing the t first, t is equal to r plus 5.